Quality Basic to me looks great and saves file space, which lets me work faster. Plus two, Clarity, leave it alone, a plus one, alone, alone, alone. I hammer that to plus three. And man, I love the way my images look.
All right, jokes aside, the interventions in the profiles do not theoretically affect the RAW file, but you're going to end up with an image in your RAW converter, Photoshop or something else, that will read this profile, and it's going to be a mess to edit. So I would not recommend doing that in the existing profiles of the camera unless you know exactly what you're doing and exactly what you want. And if you accidentally do it, then open the file in Capture NXT, the horrible slow software of Nikon, which is at least the most color accurate of all of them because it's the company's software, and revert it to the profile that supposedly fits the scene. But there is a better thing to do. If you want to tamper with such effects in camera, create separate profiles with a picture control utility. It's a Nikon software. Create your own profiles, load them in the camera so that the camera has additional profiles now. For example, a profile named manual focusing, which will be, let's say, a copy of the neutral profile, but with increased sharpness. When you increase the sharpness in the profile, it helps you in focusing. Okay, it's not actually increasing the sharpness of your lens, no. It just gives you a preview with more contrast in those critical areas, so it helps you focusing better on the back screen of the live view, right, in live view. Or a profile named TTR Landscape, which after tests you have done, you have determined the best values, but it's better to create different profiles and load them in the camera than tamper with the profiles that the camera already has. You're going to save time this way. It's going to make your life much easier and the results more predictable, more easy to control. I didn't see that video, but I'm just going to comment on the title. Zoom versus primes, zooms are for amateurs. Actually, quite the opposite.
At the time, there was a huge shift happening in photography, especially in the equipment arena, with Canon ushering in autofocus and also the fixed 2.8 zoom lenses. So lenses like the 20-35 and the 70-200 2.8, those had become the absolute norm staple for every newspaper photographer I knew.
Zoom lenses, autofocus, TTL, and all those things were created for professionals. Amateurs were given usually a camera with a fixed lens, which was also a fixed focal length. Zoom lenses actually are difficult to master in order to achieve a consistent look in your portfolio and not having any picture look completely different than the other one. I only agree with half of this test. First of all, the print size is small enough for the Sony A7R4 not to have any problems and any noise in this size print. A good crop sensor shouldn't have any noise at base ISO in this size print. But why am I saying that? Well, look, for example, the Sony versus the Hasselblad, where it's shown clearly that it's an issue of the lens, not the camera, not the resolution. Look at the bright light sources that are kind of fogging around the edges with the Sony lens, while they're very clean with the Hasselblad. Hasselblad makes some of the best medium format lenses around. All right, its medium format lenses are legendary for controlling bright light sources. Look at this. The detail level is the same. Look at the pole. At this print size, the detail level is the same, but the source light is more diffused on the Sony. Let me give you another example. Look at this part here, between the Sony and the Hasselblad. The detail level is the same. Look at the details inside the windows and everything, the details that are visible in every shot. Look at the little indoors lamp here. Right? You see that? See that little thing? It's the same. But look at the bright light sources. Look at this comparison here. Now, for this size print, I would argue that the Sony A7 R4 should not show any noise whatsoever for this print size. And yet it does, which means either that it was not shot at the base ISO or the printing profile didn't match on the printer. But to look at the light sources. Although the detail, if you look inside the windows, the detail level is the same. Do you see these little fine lines that separate the windows? They're the same. Therefore, the detail level is the same. But look at the fogging around the bright sources, the bright light sources. Look at the difference, you see? And here? That's an issue of the lens. Now, in the second part of the test, I agree with her findings that if you expose for the highlights and then you have to push up I don't know how many stops to have your subject clean, the small sensor, of course, is going to crap out. That's why I'm telling you, use flash. Now, for the new viewers, as far as printing size is concerned and clarity and what have you, go at this video from Artbit Studios. And they have here an example where they showed to photographers, professional photographers, and they could not find a difference in detail between 300 ppi and 150 ppi. But let's be generous and start printing at 200 ppi. Here, my daughter took this from inside the car with a D500 and the kit zoom lens. This is a RAW file. Let's open it up in Photoshop, right? Or we're gonna see how much we can print it, how big we can print it without upscaling it, right? Because it defaults at 300, right? It defaults at 300. But I'm gonna say 200. At 200, and we saw that between 150 and 300 is really no difference if the lens has good acutance, visual difference. Now we have 27 by 18, which is the size that these guys talked about. This is not upscaling. I do not have this checked. It's not resampled, not upscaling. That's ordinary print. And what you see actually is 138 ppi, because this is how much my monitor can display and processed via YouTube, and I don't know how much your monitors can display. 138 ppi. And this guy, as you can remember, I'm re-showing it for the new viewers, this guy could not find any difference between the same size prints that the guys from Slant Lens printed, between the Fuji X-T3 and the GFX50R. Crop sensor versus medium format. Couldn't find any difference, because there is no difference to be seen at this print size for the given resolution of, let's say, 200 or 250 or 300 ppi. But what really puzzled me, besides the lens fogging around bright light sources, was that I detected a sort of a noise that should not be there in the Sony files at base ISO. So either the ISO was floating or the printing profile did not actually agree with the Sony, because this happens as well. At this print size, you should not be able to see any noise with the Sony A7 R4 or the A7 R3. No noise whatsoever, and still there is noise versus the Hasselblad. While the detail is the same, there is noise, which is impossible for this print size. So probably the ISO floored or the printing profile did not agree. This is also a possibility. So overall, I only agree with half of this test, this part, where they push shadows up, I don't know how many stops, when you expose for the background. That's why I'm saying use a flash. The rest, I do not know. But a lot of people are testing now the new Hasselblad, and there is obviously a push from the company to sell more cameras and stuff in these difficult times. But they should be comparing big prints, not small ones. For the new viewers, I'm gonna reshow this image. You can see the details here, right? It's a TIFF file. And I strongly recommend to you to actually see your files to first turn them into TIFF, convert them into TIFF. Otherwise, what you see is an embedded JPEG crop. That's the histogram, which shows that most of the image is actually underexposed, as it is shown from the image. It is also slightly upscaled, but not corrected in any way, as it is obvious. The focus point was here, towards the right side on this tree trunk. So let's check it out. Do you see any noise or any loss of detail? Look at the details of the little branches. And right now, what I am seeing is a monitor at 138 ppi. 138 ppi, 32 inches diagonal. And this is 1/15th of the image. 1/15th of the image. See any problems here? Any noise? This is an NEF file. The raw file is displayed when I double click on it and it opens up with this viewer. These are the details, as you can see. This is the histogram. NEF, you see? NEF. I don't know, good enough for you? Where is the noise? Where is the loss of detail? Only this part of the video I agree with. The rest I cannot really, for three reasons. There is unexplained noise in the Sony file on these images here, the first ones that they played, which should not be there at base ISO at that print size. No, sir. There is fogging of the Sony lens around the bright light sources. But most importantly, why isn't the Fuji GFX100 in the test? It's less than half the price of the Hasselblad if you get a few lenses. Why isn't it in the test? So, I don't know. Thanks a lot. Bye.